it still really feels like we're exploring the unknown, which is kind of exciting and fun in this day and age. These colder outbreaks come off of the Arctic sea ice. Air has been sitting there for a while. It's cold. Synoptics will come along and push that air over the open water. During that time, they're picking up heat and moisture off of the ocean. They develop these beautiful patterns that you can see on satellite imagery from space. But when they hit the Norwegian coast, they also produce extreme amounts of snowfall.
Cold air outbreaks are very important for a number of reasons. In terms of the transfer of heat from the ocean to the atmosphere, these cold air outbreaks make about 22% of that flux that exists across the Earth.
They're a hazard to shipping along the coast, and they're also a bit unpredictable. They come about on pretty short time scales, and we still don't quite have a good sense of the when and where and, you know, the impact of them.
And what is even more important is that we know that the Arctic is warming up at a rate much faster than the rest of the planet. And it's also warming up at a rate faster than our climate models can predict.
So as the Arctic climate changes, and in particular we're losing sea ice, we expect these colder outbreaks to spend more time over the open water. So we would think that we should be getting even more snowfall from these as they hit land.
Well, what is most unique about this field campaign is our ability to see how the properties of the air masses change and evolve as they move from the origin to the warmer waters further south.
Colder outbreak clouds have really not been studied in much detail, certainly not in situ, that means at the flight level. There have been observations from above, there have been observations from the coast, but observations over the full length of these cloud regimes from where they start along the Arctic ice edge downwind over a distance of maybe 1,000 kilometers is really unprecedented.
So we're lucky because we have this NSF C-130 plane, which is a big bumblebee of a plane.
It's really suitable for two reasons. One, it goes out far, so it makes it out to the Arctic ice edge and back. The other reason is that the C-130 is a large laboratory, able to host several instruments at once.
We have both remote sensing instruments. This would include things like the Wyoming Cloud LiDAR and the Wyoming Cloud Radar. They can give information on the properties of the clouds and aerosols that we retrieve remotely. We also have drop sondes, so these are like regular radio sondes that are launched all around the world every 12 hours a day. They can also be dropped out of the aircraft, and it gives good profiles of both temperature, moisture, and winds as they descend through the atmosphere. Then we also have what are called in situ probes. These are probes that work when the aircraft is actually flying through that location of the cloud we want to measure the property, or sometimes underneath the cloud where we want to measure the aerosol particles, which are the embryos of cloud droplets.
So upload usually lasts, depending on the project, anywhere from a couple weeks to a month, month and a half. This project has a lot of instruments on board, so it's a long process.
All of the scientists who are bringing their instrumentation to the field have to give us a lot of specifications about that instrumentation, the power load that it's going to need on the airplane, its weight for things like weight and balance. You can imagine you're flying a plane, things have to be balanced right.
You've got to hook it up to the computers inside and methodically test everything to make sure that everything's hooked up well, you're not getting electronical noise or interference on your lines. So, you know, once that team's happy, then the next instrument team comes in and then they'll integrate their instrument.
So once we've got all the instrumentation on board and everybody's feeling good, we get everybody loaded up, people get to bring their families out, they come watch the plane on the tarmac and, you know, wave goodbye as we fly away, and we're off to the field.